So if you have an iPhone 6S, 6S Plus, 7 or 7 Plus, then you've got a 3D touchscreen, meaning that you can press down hard on the screen and it reacts different than if you just normally touch the screen. And you can use that to turn your keyboard into a trackpad. So here I am in Notes, and I'm going to, instead of just tapping lightly on the keyboard like you might do to type, I'm going to press down harder on the keyboard and you'll see the keys will go away. And now I don't have to keep pressing down hard. I can now just have my finger normally on the keyboard. You can see I can move the cursor around just like if I was using a trackpad on a Mac. So I press down hard, but now I'm not pressing down hard anymore. I'm just kind of rolling my finger over, but I've never lost contact with the screen. As soon as I lose contact, it goes back to a normal keyboard and the cursor stays where I left it. So I press down hard again and now I can move around again. Now you can also select text this way. The way you do it, it's very tricky and takes lots of practice, is you press down hard and then you're not pressing hard anymore. You're just having a normal contact, and then you press hard again without ever releasing contact, and it starts a selection where it selects that word, and now I can move the cursor to increase the selection. And if I release, I have that selection there and I can delete or start typing to replace what's there. Also, I'll just do it again here. I've just tapped down hard. Now I'm just having normal contact with the screen. If I tap quickly twice, it will select the entire line. So I've kept contact with the screen the entire time, but I've pressed down hard twice. Again, this takes practice and it's a little getting used to. But once you get used to it, you can manipulate text in any app. This could be Notes, Pages, Mail, Safari, a third-party app that lets you edit text. Anything that uses the standard keyboard is going to let you use the keyboard as a trackpad. And once you get the hang of it, it's much easier to manipulate text than trying to use your finger to tap on the screen and position exactly where the cursor should be. Now you can also do the same on the iPad, even though the iPad doesn't have 3D touch. The way it works on the iPad is you use two fingers and you tap with two fingers on the keyboard and it changes to a cursor, and you can do the same thing just using two fingers instead of one. For selection, use two fingers and wait before you do your first movement. So tap down with two fingers, hold, and it changes to a selection, and then you drag, and then you could do a selection with that. So it works a little different, but it's the same basic concept on the iPad. I'm using iOS 10 on both of these devices, although this works in iOS 9 as well.